Turkish President Recep Tayyip Erdogan has proposed securing the airport in Afghanistan, the capital Kabul, to improve US-Turkish relations as NATO and US troops complete their withdrawal from war-torn Afghanistan. But the Taliban's recent warning to Turkey highlights the military and diplomatic challenges facing Turkey's offer.
9/11, the day that changed America. Now they're here, closing out the chapter on America's longest war.
I'm very grateful to be a part of it. I've been here for 20 years, so this is, the war has started before I was born, so it's like a crazy that I get to be here to close it down.
As the size of foreign diplomatic missions in Afghanistan dwindles, the security of Kabul Airport is now of paramount importance. Afghanistan is a landlocked country, and the airport is the only gateway to other parts of the world. The Taliban recently warned Turkey of expanding its military presence in Afghanistan to secure Kabul Airport, and the consequences of Turkish officials' refusal to reconsider their decision and to continue occupying the country. The Taliban aren't happy. The statement came days after Turkish President Recep Tayyip Erdogan said the United States and Turkey had agreed on the dimensions of a mission to secure Kabul Airport following the withdrawal of foreign troops. Friends, who are the United States and Turkey to discuss Kabul Airport? Taliban are children of Afghanistan. Shouldn't they determine what happens on their land? According to Erdogan, the Taliban are occupying Afghanistan. I wonder where he was when NATO and US decided to occupy Afghanistan, Iraq, Libya, Somalia, and the list continues. This man seems to change like the British weather. Turkey's offer to run and secure Kabul's key airport was formally made during Erdogan's first meeting with US President Joe Biden on the sidelines of a NATO summit back in June. Erdogan also sought permission from Macron, who supposedly is an enemy of Islam. The security of Kabul Airport is important, and it's become an immediate concern for many NATO nations, and Turkey seems to be pleased with the offer from countries trying to cope with the consequences of the US withdrawal from Afghanistan. Turkey wants to run the show in Kabul, Afghanistan. But the Taliban's strong opposition to Turkey in recent days shows that the Taliban are determined to succeed. They've negotiated the deal in Qatar, and Kabul Airport was not a topic in Doha. Taliban had no idea NATO member Turkey would be running the airport. The Taliban are looking forward to a victory in the 20-year US war, and victory would be incomplete if they have no access to their own airport in Kabul. Turkey's offer of Kabul Airport has been in Afghan political circles for months, and the Taliban's recent warning to Erdogan came as no surprise to most analysts. Most analysts are now of the opinion that Turkey might be a Trojan horse of NATO and is trying to fool the Muslim world. Details of the number of troops needed to secure Kabul Airport have not been released, and Turkish Defense Minister Kulusi Akar has ruled out an increase in the number of troops in the country's 500-strong unit in Afghanistan. It's also unclear whether Turkish troops will operate under a NATO command or under the Turkish flag, such as Ankara's military mission in Syria, Libya, and the Nagorno-Karabakh region on the border between Armenia and Azerbaijan. After the Taliban warning to Erdogan, Turkish security operatives know the operations in Afghanistan are dangerous without diplomatic cover from NATO or the United Nations. Therefore, Turkey will have to do NATO and UN's bidding in Afghanistan if it wants to control Kabul Airport. In a statement a few days ago, Erdogan said he hoped Pakistan would participate in securing the airport, but analysts say that's easier said than done. Islamabad has so far refused to allow the United States to carry out airstrikes on Afghanistan, and any Pakistani involvement in any Turkish mission has its own consequences. The Pakistani military's powerful intelligence agency has long been a senior supporter of the Taliban regime, although governments in Pakistan have denied any support for the group, saying they have limited influence over the Taliban group. The Taliban have also insisted that they are not influenced by Pakistan, but the United States negotiators have denied this, noting that Taliban representatives regularly fly to Pakistan to consult with their leaders. And they've been doing this during the US-Taliban peace talks in Qatar. TV channels supporting Erdogan shows experts praising the Turkish president's recent move to expand Ankara's influence in Afghanistan, but critics question this NATO mission. In the past, the Turkish people have supported Erdogan's military actions to varying degrees. Overwhelming majority supported operations against the PKK in Iraq and Syria, while only 30% supported Ankara's involvement in the Libyan crisis. So folks, it's quite obvious right now, Erdogan is playing the NATO game and will probably be pushed to deploy Turkish troops in an operational capacity out there in Afghanistan, and there will be clashes. The reputation that the Turkish army has built in Afghanistan through fairy tale Hollywood style drama serials like Ertugrul in the last few years can easily fall in a blink of an eye.
Why are they in
this guide? It is a guide, not my people, it is guide.
Al-Qaeda.
Guide, yeah.